Now, when I was a young man about 21 years old, y'all, all I wanted was a stripper girlfriend and a gold top Les Paul. Be careful of the things you wish for. You might get them. There was a nightclub in Dallas. It's called Mother of Blues. It's where Lightning Hopkins played and Freddy King even paid some dues. All the dealers and gamblers and young white hipsters, they all made the scene. The girl at the door who checked IDs was just 16. Ah, it was not a place for law-abiding citizens. Jackie Jones, he had him a habit. He just couldn't stop. He said, give me $500 and I sell you my Les Paul gold top. I drove my daddy's car down to Ross Avenue and I sold it. I guess I should have told him, alluded to the police, and someone stole it. Oh, it was just the first of many bad decisions I was to make for the next 20 years. Oh, but I had me a guitar. Now looking at y'all, since y'all are here for the late show, I know that you all understand when I say that the real nightlife begins after the clubs close. What they call after hours. Oh, yeah. So it's 2 a.m. and everybody's gone but the band, the dealers, and Jack Jones. And then the girls from the Landing Strip Club come over after they put the clothes back on. So I'm at my blues. I'm sitting on an amp. I'm playing Twist and Shout. And this tall drink of water walk in, look like she might have to shoot her way out. She come up to me, she says, you know anything good on that guitar? I didn't say nothing, I just kept on playing. She said, have you ever heard this song called Polk Salad Annie? I just kept on playing. She said, every time I hear that song, my insides feel like warm butter and I just want to take off my clothes and dance around in my underwear. I said, down in Louisiana, where the alligator grows so mean, chomp, chomp. That's all I knew of it. Maybe I didn't know that much. But that's all I knew. But so we hit it off. We hit it off. Me and this dancer, we hit it off like a metaphor. We hit it off like a metaphor for a hydrogen bomb. It was enriched uranium, supercritical mass. We was a chain reaction. It was a love and lust, mostly lust, but a mutual attraction. So there I was, boys, at 21 years old. I had it all. I had a fine stripper girlfriend and a gold top Les Paul. Ah, the future, it looked promising. Ah, but there were dark clouds on the horizon. She was a beautiful girl, but she liked to drink tequila. Yeah, that ain't all. I come home 4 or 5 times and she pawned my Les Paul. We broke up and she went to Hollywood. She married her an actor. She got a job dancing on the Hudson Brothers TV show and modeling lipstick for Max Factor. Ah, I'm glad she done all right. I got over her. I really did. I'm glad she done all right. Yes, I am. Yes, I am. But now me, I never busted through the gates into the big time as a rock and roll star. For 40 years, I just carried around an old gold top guitar. But love and fate are mysterious things in this funky old world. It was 23 years ago, I ended up marrying that Mother Blues door girl. We had us a boy, he's 18 years old now. He's playing guitar. He ended up with that Les Paul. What does he do? He trades it for an SG. I don't know if he's gonna hang his life on it or not, you know, but I'm grateful for the time I get to share the stage with my son, and I'm grateful for the time I get to share the stage with George Reeve and Rick Richards, and I'm glad and grateful I get to write these old songs and travel around the world and play them for people. And you know, the days that I keep my gratitude higher than my expectations, is I have really good days, and this has been a really good day.